Hi, welcome to Unit 4 of Financial Management. Till now, we have covered two important decisions in finance. We have seen financing decision and investment decision. Financing decision we cover in Unit 1 and 3, and you focused on cost on capital, capital structure and leverage. You saw the various things which you need to take into consideration when a firm acquires funds. You saw the various sources, the minimum return to be given in the form of cost of capital, the proportion of various funds in the form of cost of capital, in the form of capital structure, and the risk element involved, which we call it as leverage. Now, when we moved on to Unit 2, in Unit 2 you saw the investment part, that is investment decision, you saw capital budgeting. We saw various methods of capital budgeting, how various methods play a role when investment decisions are to be taken. A third decision in finance is regarding your dividend decision. Now, when we wanted funds from the public, we got through various sources. We invested the funds in various activities. Now, in activities will give you return. Now, over here we decide, should the profit be distributed or should the profit be retained back in the business? And if the profits are distributed in the form of dividend to the owners, how, in what form and how do we distribute them? Now, this is an important decision which you make under dividend decision. If you remember how profits are to be distributed, EBIT minus interest is PBT, PBT minus tax is PAT, PAT minus preference dividend is earnings available to shareholders. At earnings available to shareholders, we decide how much earnings to be given in the form of profits and how much earnings to be retained back in the business in the form of reserves or retained earnings. That's what we are going to do. How do we decide that? That is what we are going to cover in today's session, focusing on the third decision of finance, that is a dividend decision. So we'll divide today's session into three topics. And the first topic will cover what are dividends and the various factors which affect the dividend decisions. We'll go to second topic. In second topic, we'll see the various dividend policy. The third topic for this session, we'll see the various forms of dividend. So by the end of the session, you should be able to explain the concept of dividend and various factors affecting it. Describe the various dividend policies and describe the various forms of dividend.